My name is Onyeka Nwelwe. Everybody calls me Black Baron of Paris. I'm in the city of New York, and I would like to introduce you to Dr. Onjakiri Damages.
Welcome to the show. My name is Dr. Damages. We're coming to you from the greatest city in the world,
New York City!
Yes, yes, yes.
Hey.
New York City is so great.
It's great.
Oh, yeah. That Manhattan, where we are now, was purchased from Native Americans.
Native Americans?
In 1626.
Hey. 1626.
For what is today's equivalent of $1,000.
What? That chicken change?
$1,000 only. I know you have it in your pocket. $1,000. Meanwhile,
Central Park,
which is a small part of Manhattan,
uh-huh,
alone is worth about $1 trillion today.
What?
$1 trillion. Yeah. Dollars? Guess who negotiated the deal in 1626?
Donald Trump.
D.H. Trump. Trump with an F.
Trump with an F.
Hey. Mind you.
Trump.
That Trump is not connected. It's not this current president.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. But it's a distant relation of this current president.
Hey, really?
Oh, yeah. And I must say this. He immigrated from Germany.
Ah.
But now, illegally, I have to add that one. Without visa. But he negotiated the deal for us.
Uh-huh.
And bought that land for nothing.
Mm.
From Native Americans.
Really nothing.
Yeah. And kicked them out. You know, the same thing he wants to do to the Latinos.
Hey.
Anyway, talking about negotiations and costs and deals.
Okay.
How much does it cost to move America's embassy in Israel from Tel Aviv to Jerusalem?
How much? I don't know.
60 Palestinian lives.
Hey!
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
60?
What?
I know. Hey.
You must have seen the videos and the pictures.
Mm-hmm.
Over 60 Palestinians were killed by Israeli soldiers.
Oh my God.
Yeah, during the protests over the taking of their land in 1948 and the moving of America's embassy to Jerusalem.
Hey, Jerusalem?
A city that they also claim it should be the capital of their own state.
So
here is how Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu described the day.
What a glorious day. Remember this moment.
I know.
Unbelievable. What a glorious day.
Mm.
You know, just before you get upset, Donald Trump's son-in-law, you know, Gerard, had a great message for you delivered on the same day.
Mm-hmm.
Take a look.
I believe peace is within reach.
Ah!
I told you. So, you see, didn't I say... Peace is within reach.
Mm.
Okay. Let the man finish his speech. Let's.
If we dare to believe that the future can be different from the past, that we are not condemned to relive history, and that the way things were is not how they must forever be.
Now, depending on who you are and what your politics is,
You
may be the bear today, or the one who takes selfie with the bear.
Uh-huh.
And tomorrow, the reverse might be the case.
Uh-huh.
Life is that way. You know, vice versa.
Listen.
Mm. Or you may be in this camp. Take a look.
Donald Trump recognized history. He, like King Cyrus before him, fulfilled the biblical prophecy of the gods worshipped by Jews, Christians, and yes, Muslims, that Jerusalem is the eternal capital of the Jewish state.
I know.
You know,
Oh my God.
Unbelievable.
Hey.
I always forget.
Mm-hmm.
It is written. You know, Trump is just fulfilling the prophecy.
Aha!
Just a reminder, the people saying this about this prophecy were the same people who said Obama was the Antichrist.
Uh-huh.
Remember that?
Yes,
Whatever happened to that prophecy?
I don't know.
Do you go from Antichrist to Trump?
Antichrist to Trump?
Unbelievable people. Oh, it's going to be a long day before the old order gets a new face. As against the new order getting an old face.
Yes.
I don't think I'm saying this right. You know what? Let's get the new star of the politics in Zimbabwe to come and explain it for us.
Yes.
Nelson Chamisa. Nelson, he will say it right. What?
He has refused to be the face of the new order. In fact, he has chosen to be the new face of the old order.
Ah!
Listen. The leader of the opposition party in Zimbabwe was talking about the Zimbabwean president. You know him, MSN.
Yeah.
But he could have as well be talking about Trump and how he's handling the Israeli-Palestinian issue. You know,
he
could also be talking about Buhari of Nigeria. You know, could be. Yeah. About the old order and trying to get a new face and new face. You know what I mean?
Yes.
Now.
Older than the other.
Nelson Chamisa also was on BBC. That interview was on BBC Hard Talk.
Mm.
How I wish anyone who wants to be president in Africa will make him or herself available on a TV show as probing as Hard Talk.
Hey!
Can you imagine Buhari on Hard Talk?
Ah!
You see, this young opposition leader, Nelson, said that he will solve Zimbabwe's liquidity problem in 2 weeks.
What?
The cash flow. He will solve it in 2 weeks.
He's a genius.
Look at the encounter on Hard Talk. Watch.
In January, you told the people of your country that you could solve Zimbabwe's liquidity crisis in 2 weeks. And indeed, if you fail to do so, you would leave office because you said you are committed. 2 weeks to solve the liquidity crisis. I mean, that's nonsense, isn't it?
It's not nonsense. It's very sensible. In fact, that is the most credible message that has ever been received by Zimbabweans.
Ah!
It is nonsense. It is not nonsense. It is silly. It is not silly. You see, doesn't that remind you of President Muhammadu Buhari as a candidate in 2015? Remember?
Yes, I remember.
He said he would solve the Boko Haram problem in 6 months.
Yes.
In fact, on August 15, 2015, Buhari gave the Nigerian military 3 months to end Boko Haram.
Correct.
3 months. I remember.
Yes, I remember that.
When his pastor vice president came out of that meeting,
the
media said to him, "Is that true? Can the military do that?" Look at his hand.
Has already given those orders. That's the commander-in-chief's orders. The chief of defense staff has already responded appropriately by saying that that is a task that has been set for the military and that they must go out and execute it and execute that task within the time that has been given.
Ah!
No. See, being that it was Nigeria's media, nobody told him that's silly. Nobody said to him, That's nonsense. It. No, they couldn't do that. They just looked at him with a bad eye.
Mm.
And the VP doubled down. Watch.
I'm extremely, I know that that is entirely possible. I know that they can do it. And we have a great military.
Ah!
You see, 3 years after, we have moved from, we have a great military, to begging President Donald Trump to give us 2 fighter jets.
I know.
While we wait for the other delivery of the other 10. In 2020. As if it was the only thing stopping them from defeating Boko Haram.
I know.
They're making it look like if you give them this plan now, they'll defeat Boko Haram. And remember the Nigeria's power minister, Babatunde Fashola?
Yes.
How he will solve the electric problem in Nigeria in 6 months.
Yes, he said that.
Look at the headline. Look at the headline. He said he will solve the power problem in 6 months. Now, I know that the minister had denied ever saying that. But here is the man talking about power generation as governor of Lagos State.
Power generation is not rocket science. It's just generator. So just remember and imagine that I better pass my neighbor in 1 million times its capacity. But in one place. So if you can make that size of 1 kilowatt, you can make a power turbine of 1,000 megawatts.
He said that power generation is not rocket science.
It is.
That's what he said. Mm. That is very simple. Mm. You just connect one of your generator to another one and 1 million of them and voila! Electric everywhere. You know what I mean?
Light everywhere.
How long have they been in power? How long has he been the minister of power? You see, that's why Dr. Damages tells them nonsense.
Mm.
As soon as they say something that is absolutely nonsense.
Yes.
Maybe I should also add that don't be silly. You don't need to wait until 4 years when they come back to you and beg for a vote to re-elect them before you tell them off.
Absolutely.
Once they say something nonsense, you tell them off.
Right away.
Telling people off. Nigeria's Inspector General of Police has been dodging every summon to appear before the Senate.
Uh-huh. Why?
At first, I thought it was out of stubbornness. I was even screaming that that man was out of control. He would disobey the president's order to go to Benue State.
Right, yes.
He went to Taraba to see the girlfriend. He disobeyed the Senate's demand for him to show up and explain why the police force in Nigeria has failed to contain the killings across Nigeria. I found myself even saying that he should be removed and replaced but with a smart, active deputy commissioner of police.
Correct.
Abba Kaira. You know the guy? Not the relation. He's not connected to the Emir of Aso Rock. I mean, Buhari's chief of staff. They're different. They're different.
They're two different people.
They're different people. And then I saw this video. Watch.
The effective transmission, apprehensive transmission in the transmission, cultivative transmission.
Unbelievable.
Hey!
Was at that event? I mean, a transmission in the brain. I mean, effective and comprehensive. I mean, transformation command. I mean,
this is one of our IG.
Listen. I have never done this before on this show. But I want to apologize to the Inspector General of Police for asking that he should be fired. That would be a mean thing to do to such a man who obviously needs our help. Don't you think? Please,
that's right.
Listen to him again and you will begin to understand the kind of help he needs from us.
Wow.
Bear in mind that English is not our mother tongue.
90% of all kidnapping transmission, other effective transmission, other transmission.
I mean, transmission in the brain. I mean, effective and apprehensive. Transformation. Now, what help do you think the man needs? No, not adult education. Now, get them mates. Not adult education. Not someone to interpret why he speaks in his mother tongue, Nupe. The man should have been speaking Nupe instead of English. What the IG needs is a return to where he started his career before quota system and federal character and disadvantaged states. You know, these are programs that are moving up. The man should go back to his former job as yellow fever police. is that not what he was doing before? Traffic police, yeah? Do you know that this man graduated from Ahmadu Bello University? The man graduated from Ahmadu Bello University. Agriculture.
We have to invest in the certificate.
He even went to law school at University of Maiduguri.
Hey!
I wanted to go there and study here. Can you believe that? He even went to the Institute of Policy and Strategic Studies.
Hey!
I wonder how he passed the exams in this place. Can you believe that? It's unbelievable. Inspector, this is an embarrassment.
Real embarrassment.
I mean, I'm sure the man has an explanation. He must have been drunk.
The Commissioner of Police in the state of Kano State Command. Rajarabi. The Commissioner of Police in charge of the monitoring unit.
Not possible. How could... No, not possible. I mean, come on. I'm apprehensive. That's Nigeria for you. This is you are. When he goes to a meeting of all the African Inspector General of Police, is that how he speaks to them? Was the IG drunk? I'm apprehensive. Here is an ongoing example of what I'm talking about. You know the Dapchi school girl,
right?
Who is still in detention with Boko Haram people. You know, you don't have. Yeah, Sharibu. Now, the one that refused to convert to Islam.
Right.
Leah Sharibu.
Yes.
It has passed 90 days.
What?
Since she was captured. Yeah, 3 months. Look at the headline.
Oh, this is poor girl.
This is from CNN. Look at it. Look at it. It's a sad story.
Very sad.
Now, in fact, she has become a political tool in the hands of Nigerian politicians and church leaders. They drop her name as if they cared about her. Now, here is the vice president of Nigeria talking about her. She said that the cross will deliver her. The cross will deliver her. Not Nigerian military. No, the cross will deliver. Look at the headline.
It has done the prayers.
No, no. I'm coming to that. Yep. The cross we deliver Leah from Boko Haram. Uh-huh. Here is Pastor Enoch Adeboye praying for Leah. Look at it. Look at it.
Wow.
Yeah, it's now prayers. We just pray. You know, that's it. That's it. Now, this is where I say nonsense. But this is a serious issue. Guess what? Right. None of these loud mouths cared. A Nigerian journalist, Chika Odua, went to visit the family of Leah. She met with the mother of Leah Sharibu.
Sharibu.
She met the mother of Leah Sharibu. Look at the picture.
Wow.
Leah's mother said that nobody has come to see her since her daughter was abducted.
Hey!
No reporter, no government official, and sadly, no church leader.
Hey, yeah.
Yep, no church leader. And these church leaders use her daughter's name to score political points.
Mm.
None has thought of going to check on the family.
Oh.
And one reason why they own private jets is to get to wherever the work of God was needed without delaying at the airport and all this cancellation of flights.
I know.
Dapchi, they won't go. Apparently not Dapchi. Too remote for them.
Mm-hmm.
Nonsense.
Nonsense.
Nonsense. You know, now, talking of church leaders, you know, we normally talk about prosperity preachers like Adeboye, Oyedepo, and all those.
Yes, I know.
Bishop Okonkwo, all of them. You know, we talk about them. But this Christ is brewing in Anglican Church.
Hey!
The Archbishop of Lagos,
uh-huh,
Adebola Ademowo, of Lagos Diocese, has been entangled in scandals involving the use of church funds.
What?
Oh, yeah. Here are some of the charges leveled against the Archbishop. Watch.
All the allegations against the Archbishop include subtle tenure elongation for Archbishop Ademowo, facilitation of a multi-million naira house for primate Nicholas Oko in the Lekki area of Lagos, outrageous retirement package of about 250 million naira, collection of 200 million naira to build retirement house for himself.
Millions and millions of naira. Now, this is happening within the church where some pastors have no cars and no houses to live. Pastors moving around, nothing.
Now,
of course, the Archbishop has his own defense. Here is the Archbishop's defense.
What? In a response to the petition and allegation, the clergyman explained that, quote, "It is an established fact that houses are built for retiring bishops as well as vehicles purchased for them by their diocese," end of quote. He also argued that, quote, "Diocese of Lagos West built a house in Lagos for the Right Reverend Peter Adebi at a cost of over 200 million naira in 2013. End of quote.
So the man of God put up a defense. It is tradition to do these things for bishops. You know, that's what he said. It is tradition. Now, here is the reaction of the church members to the bishop's defense. Take a look.
Not convinced by this response, the disaffection between these members and their spiritual leader snowballed into this heavy security presence in and around the church.
Now, the reporter is good. The reporter went and asked the bishop, "What do you think about this drama? You know, this drama." And the bishop lied. I'm telling you, brace yourself because you are going to see an archbishop of the Church of Nigeria lying in broad daylight. Watch.
So, can you tell us, are you privy to some of the drama happening outside the church?
No, there was no drama. There was no drama. There, you know, area boys, they normally make noise. So, they were babblers. They were just making noise. It's usual for people to make noise. I think they were excited. They were excited to see us.
There's no drama, you know. It's usual people making noise. I think they are excited to see us. see, they were there was no noise. Look, can you imagine that? Now, I don't know where the Archbishop saw people who were excited, but watch the excitement of the Archbishop's church members. Watch again.
You see,
how about a Archbishop, eh? You can lie like that, eh? How about? Remember, there is God.
There is God, though.
And this camera is bigger than this TV camera that you are looking at. I'm telling you, God's camera is bigger than the TV camera you're looking at, Bishop.
Yes, yes.
How can you do this? You see, the truth is that, just like politicians in Nigeria, some church leaders are also out of touch with reality. No, that's what's going on. The other day, at the meeting of his church leaders, Pastor Enoch Adeboye of the Redeemed Christian Church of God, you know him?
Yes, yes.
Was quoted to have said this, and I quote, "Are you aware that some people spend their time attacking me, particularly people on the internet? Those attacking me are actually attacking you.
Hey.
But be less assured, they will soon be sent out of this country."
Number one?
I said, "Hey, yeah." like a politician, he just made attack on him, an attack on his followers, which is wrong. When people attack you, they're attacking you, not your followers. Secondly, he pulled the greatest punishment one could give to a Nigerian, to send them out of the country.
Exactly.
It's a big punishment.
Hey.
Oh, Daddy G.O.
Hey.
Most of the people attacking you, they're already out of the country. Oga G.O., check their IP addresses, you know. Does he even know what IP? I don't think so. I doubt it. Now, things like this make you lose hope. If an archbishop will lie, just like that, what hope do you have? The politicians will lie. Now, some rich people therefore send their children abroad to avoid this nonsense.
Wow.
They said, no, you are leaving this country. Well, it is not even safe abroad. It's not. In London, two spoiled kids of Nigerian politicians were in court fighting over whose father was richer. Take a look.
Wow.
No, these are children of rich Nigerians, privileged kids, fighting over whose father was richer. No. These kids attacked each other with bottles of wine. I mean expensive wine. What is the problem? My dad is richer than your dad.
What?
I will pause for you to slap yourself and wonder who did this to us. because until we start slapping ourselves, so ask that question.
Before we wake up.
Who did this to us? Meanwhile, in America, a Nigerian graduate student at Yale University was shocked when her roommate called the police on her because she fell asleep in the common area of the university studying. Look at it.
I have every right to call the police. You cannot sleep in that room.
This white student called police on a black graduate student who fell asleep while writing a paper in the dorm's common area. Four officers respond.
This is America. Yeah, over here, people in some ways are also smiling and
smiling and suffering.
Yeah, it happens to you in America. Now, last week, Buhari visited Jigawa State. Did you see the pictures?
Yes, I saw it.
Take a look at the people who came out to welcome him. Look at that.
Yes.
I didn't see any lazy youth among them. No, nobody. You know, after seeing these pictures, Governor Ayo Fayoshe of Ekiti State was asked on a TV program, why would anybody vote for your party in the upcoming election?
Yes.
Look at his answer.
The question will be, what have you done for your party to deserve
a re-election? I don't like all this question. I am a politician of note. I'm not a... You see, yesterday I was fine Gary with some women. Let them go and meet people now. You know, this Oyibo, they are speaking all around. We never do anything. Right. I don't have time for them.
He said he's a politician of note. You know, it's not just politicians that are feeling the hate. Musicians are also feeling the hate. Last week, Tabansi Records in Onitsha cancelled the contract of a pop group that they just signed last week. After seeing what happened in Jigawa State, they cancelled the contract. Luckily for us, we have one of their songs that is already out. Take a look.
Wow.
2019 is going to be bombastical.
Bombastic!
Okay. Now, here are some stories making headline news across Nigerian newspapers this week. Pope Francis hints that he may retire. Did you hear that?
What?
Pope Francis is saying that he may retire.
Did
you hear anything from Buhari? Is he thinking about retirement too? I mean, because if the Pope is hinting, Buhari should. That's a hint.
But the previous Pope too also
retired. He's still waiting, waiting for... There'll be two retired Popes. One day they will all come out, all the retired Popes. Hey, hello, hey, hello. Hey. We are reluctant to go to see Jesus, God. We just want to hang around for a little bit more. I won't allow anybody to cheat Nigerians, says Muhammadu Buhari.
What?
I said, oh my God, it must be true. Remember that thing that he signed at the White House with Trump at his back smiling? Someone has translated it to him.
Mm-hmm.
And now he's saying, damn, I won't allow anybody to cheat Nigeria. Yeah. No.
After the
translation, he said, you know what I signed?
Oh, Lord.
Have they been cheating Nigeria and he's been looking around? Now he said, no, I won't land. That won't happen anymore.
Nonsense.
Maybe after listening to the chief of inspector of police, he said, no, this guy is cheating Nigeria. Anyway, you will attend the funeral of those who want you dead, says Pastor Ayo Enoch Adeboye.
Hey!
You will attend the funeral of those who want you dead.
Is that a curse or a prayer?
this will happen. So when Jesus had this, Jesus opened his New Testament and he was looking at he closed it and Jesus wept. Jesus wept. Is this what is this how they interpret my teaching? Jesus wept. Close the Bible and yes.
Lord Almighty. Doctor, you can
keep
person.
Who teaches this? Who is their teacher? Anyway, my man, this, I bring you one every week.
Yes, yes.
Horror as man 30 rushed to hospital after hacking his penis while watching porn.
What?
boys, there's no cause for alarm. Don't throw away your videos. No.
Which country is
porn? I don't know the country, but it doesn't matter. This is why I'm saying that porn movies should come with warnings.
The way
wits and rap songs come with warnings. Warnings like, this movie is not stable for adults who have knives at home. There are some of them that if you have knives, you don't watch it. Just if you look at it, say, go and lock up your knife because you might end up cutting. I can't believe this. It's unthinkable. It's unthinkable. You know.
But I bet you it's not in Nigeria.
No, it's not. No, it's not. No. An African won't do that. No. Africa. No. Africans will not do that. But this is a serious issue. Nonsense. It's time for your
email.
Angeline, well, nice to see you again.
Nice to see you.
Yeah,
too,
you're doing well. Is this Thank a uniform you. Of? You have halfway to getting
this
a
was,
uniform.
This was actually
just
not got my intention.
Pants.
But
you just got the pants. Yeah, but one day you will get a uniform.
Very soon.
Very soon. And nice hair.
How was your week?
This is natural now. We are going.
Black girl magic.
Do we have emails today?
Every day, doctor.
Okay, let's hear them, please.
Okay. So our first email is from Joseph in France.
Josie.
No.
Do you
know? No, not Joe.
I think it's him. Or...
Joe. Nah, let me hear.
Let's hear, okay.
Because if it's Joe, no, it won't be.
Good day, doctor.
Yes.
I'm a follower of your show.
You see, I told you.
In fact, I make sure I'm amongst the first 10 to watch it every day.
That's the real Joe.
That's Joe.
Is that Joe, right?
Yeah,
real one.
Yeah,
I want to commend you for the great work you have been doing and still doing. So nice of him.
When are we stopping in Paris?
We're going to go soon.
You shall never lack, and no man born of a woman can bring you down.
Amen. Wow. You see? These are the real pastors.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. Keep on exposing those heartless criminal politicians.
And their friends.
Who always takes us for a fool.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
I wish Sore the best and pray he wins.
Okay.
My regards to
your boss.
No, I don't know. Go ahead.
My regards to the crew members and the noisemaker.
The noisemaker! Thank you, my friend. Thank you, Joe.
Noisemaker!
Joe, thank you very much. Now, the noisemaker is back.
Hey!
He went to campaign.
Ah!
He went to campaign.
He was in Paris, actually.
He was in Europe. He wasn't here last week, but he's back.
But we will talk to him later at the end of the show. We'll see what happened. Next.
Our second email is from Yusuf in Budapest, Hungary.
Oh, yeah, Yusuf.
Yusuf, our man.
Yeah, Yusuf, our friend. Yeah, huh? Uh-huh.
Hello, Dr. Damages. Yes. My friend Joe introduced me to your show recently.
Joe! You know, I told people, if you like it, tell your friends.
Yeah!
That is how, that's how we do it.
You see?
Yeah, go ahead.
And I must say, I'm very impressed.
Wow.
I'm curious to know how you keep the talking points objective.
Wow.
And not let your emotions affect you.
Joe, this Yusuf is smart. He's, don't you think so?
Yes,
very, very smart. Intelligent guy.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Now, very good question. I always say that objectivity is relative.
Mm-hmm.
You know, our opinion is subjective.
Uh-huh.
What I strive to do is for me to be true to my conscience.
Mm.
And my conscience is a factor of my environment and my experiences.
Uh-huh. So
tell them, doctor.
Don't tweet that out. You know what I'm saying? You know, no, this is what I think. When I was critiquing about Jonathan, mm-hmm. Obasanjo and Yar'Adua.
Uh-huh.
People who like them were all up in arms.
Uh-huh.
Now it's the turn of Buhari, who is the person in charge. We have to hold them accountable.
Right?
That's what we try to do.
That's
here.
True.
That's what we try to do. Now, that's all the time we have for emails. Please keep sending your emails to Dr. Damages at
gmail.com
and follow us on Twitter at
Dr. Damages
and on Instagram at
Dr. Damages.
Here's my concern for today.
Uh-huh.
It's taken from page, from 419 minutes
uh-huh.
of Will Smith video
uh-huh.
explaining skydiving.
Uh-huh.
What?
You realize that the point of maximum danger is the point of minimum fear.
Point of maximum danger
mm-hmm.
is the point of minimum fear.
Hey!
The point of maximum danger is the point of minimum fear.
That is deep! It's deep!
Will, close it out.
God placed the best things in life on the other side of fear.
God placed the best things in life at the other end of fear.
Uh-huh.
If you can overcome fear, you'll get to the best things in life.
Uh-huh.
Until next week, I'm Dr. Damages. I diagnose
you.
That is deep. It's deep. You know, we go far to bring it. So how are things going?
Suffering and smiling.
Suffering and smiling. Don't worry, Alat is coming. Let's bring the noisemaker. Because the noisemaker went to England.
Mm.
With the campaign. It was not that guy.
So I think
we went with them. Let's stop them. Okay. Noisemaker! You were not here.
Doctor, my doctor.
What happened?
Doctor.
Yeah. Have you met the nurse?
No. Nostanjalo. Welcome to our midst. Nostanjalo, doctor. The campaign is going great.
It's going great.
We are well received. We were well received in Europe.
Yeah.
We went to London
mm-hmm.
city,
mm-hmm.
and it was a great turnout.
Yeah.
We had a whole lot of people come around from different part of England.
Wow.
And they came out into London city.
Mm-hmm.
And it was a great, great event.
Okay.
We have scheduled Ta'ol also in Nigeria.
In Nigeria.
The next one is coming up, which is.
And what are you? Are you chief of staff?
Don't worry. Well, we unfold everything.
All right.
Thank you, doctor.
So thank you for coming and reporting back to us. Uh-huh. So until next week, we will talk. Yeah.